So we are going to step up our efforts there because this is a big play and there's a lot of inventory, and we will need to find a partner, whether that's a strategic or an investment partner, to come in and help us pursue this as quickly as possible.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Zephyr Energy CEO Colin Harrington. Colin, very good to speak with you. Could you walk us through the key highlights from this latest well test and what makes these results significant?
Sure, happy to do so, and nice to see you. We are really, really excited about the results of this test. We were doing something that was novel, first of a kind in this basin, and things went exactly to plan operationally. We're really, really happy with how this turned out. So I think the key takeaways for me, highlights, obviously flow rates. We saw some exceptional flow rates here, and I'll put that into context in a minute, but these tests, I should point out, they're really highly structured when you undertake them. So you start by cracking the choke just a tiny bit, and you run the well, let it clean up, and you see where it settles in at that highly choked place. And here we were well above where we thought we'd be at the smallest setting of the choke. So we were doing between 700 and over 1,000 barrels a day for a consistent period of time, and weren't seeing any pressure drawdown. So that's a great, great sign. As we opened up and started producing with just slightly more choke, this thing really took off to the point where we're close to exceeding our infrastructure, our production testing infrastructure equipment. So we got up to almost 3,000 barrels a day. We could have gone more if we wanted to, but as I said, at that point, we were running the risk and we were getting the data that we need. So very, very happy with the production levels. Let me just put it into context, though, because I think there's, among some areas, a lack of understanding what a good rate, good onshore US rate looks like. For comparable basins with us, for 1 mile laterals and wells that have been fracked, and ours wasn't fracked, but a decent rate would be somewhere between 500 and 750 a day, and that would tail off fairly quickly as well. Here we're seeing higher levels than that, much higher levels when you look at what it can do when we open up the choke. And that's with no frack. It's just a really good result. It's obviously early days, but from the standpoint of what this can produce, it's definitely in the highest quartile of US onshore wells that are 1 mile, adjusted for this size. Other highlights, as I think about it, we saw elevated liquid yields again, which is great. That helps drive the economics really well, although we're very bullish on natural gas right now, too. Very little produced water, which is excellent. It helps with disposal costs. This acid design that we tested, it's now the second time we've used it. Clearly, it's a great way to complete the wells here. We've got another data point, and it went exactly to plan. So I'm thrilled with the overall results here. Now we've got to take all the data we've gotten and start to crunch it.
You've mentioned clear commerciality based on this production test, Colin. What are the indicators that give you confidence that this well can support a commercial development?
Oh, I mean, if for this single well, it's more than enough to install gas processing equipment and produce this as a commercial well. It's got a lot of rate here. There's no question in our minds that this is a clearly commercial well.
The data suggests strong inflow across the full 5,000-foot lateral, especially compared to your earlier test. What does this mean in terms of reservoir potential and future production upside?
Yeah, it's an interesting question. I should step back a little bit by saying that we took an unusual step with the design of this well. We elected to run a fibre optic cable that was designed by Halliburton all the way down behind the tubing of the pipe in the well. And that allowed us to get a huge amount of data. You don't see this often, but we are absolutely in data gathering mode. And it's not just so we understand how to design and complete wells better, but also so industry partners can look at it with us. And there's just a huge and very rich data set here. So at a high level, it looks great. You're right. The whole length of the lateral is producing, and we can see exactly from which fractures we're seeing the most production, but it's pretty uniform across things. And it was very much in line with our models. So that was nice to see that the data lined up there. We got high level messages around productivity, contributing well length, like we've just talked about, the type of reservoir flow from fractures and matrices. So there's quite a bit there that we can now take and put into our model. So we're going to take all of this analysis, which will ultimately lead, as they crunch it, to an EUR estimate, which will give us, a total estimated potential of the well.
Finally, how do these initial results shape your next steps for the broader Paradox project? And what are the next steps for the company that investors and stakeholders should expect in the coming months?
Yeah, well, let's start with the latter half of that question. In terms of next steps, the biggest one for us right now is taking the data, analyzing it, and coming back with our evaluation of what the reserves look like here. As part of that, we're getting fluid samples, and we'll have that testing back pretty soon. And then we take everything that we've done and we'll give it to the third-party reservoir engineering firm and get an updated CPR on this. So that's kind of the data from around the well itself. We'll be working with our gas marketing partners and the company that's designing the processing for us. We'll make a decision on how to size it and begin the process of turning this from a a discovery well into something that throws off cash flow. So that's going to be a big focus for us. We're obviously, as I mentioned before, going to be talking with industry partners on this. It's been a wonderful day. I've had so many texts from American friends in the industry here who have seen the results and are excited for us. So we are going to step up our efforts there because this is a big play and there's a lot of inventory and we will need to find a partner, whether that's a strategic or an investment partner, to come in and help us pursue this as quickly as possible.
Colin, I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress with that. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
My pleasure. It's great to see you and thanks again.
And to you, Colin Harrington, the CEO of Zephyr Energy.